Okay, fine. Is the screen share visible? Acknowledge in the chat box. Is the screen share visible? Okay, fine. Yeah, thank you, students. Thank you. Thanks. Okay, so last lecture I had done with you all objectives of cost accounting or objectives of costing. I explained that one example out of which all the five objectives were explained to you all. Okay, so now this lecture we are going to do cost classification. Okay, we're gonna do cost classification. Cost classification. What is this cost classification concept? The chapter name is Introduction to Cost Accounting. Okay. And the associated chapter to this is, cost sheet. Okay. So I told it in the very beginning when I started with the syllabus, that cost classification will be an extension to the first chapter. Okay. It's an extension only. In many textbooks, if you see textbooks, they have taken it under the first chapter. Okay, but it is actually an extension to the first chapter. Okay, you can even study this along with cost sheet. Clear? So, to understand cost classification, okay, to understand this concept, you have to first understand the basics of cost. So next 1 minute, I'll be locking the meeting room. Okay. So now understand this and see how I'm going to relate it. Okay. Divided as direct and indirect. Okay. It's direct as well as indirect. Now, this word which I'm using, this one, okay, this word is a financial accounting term. In financial accounting, you call it expenses, okay? But in cost accounting, expenses are known as cost. Anyone has any doubt till here? Put it in the chat box. Is this clear? Financial accounting mein, the word is expenses. There we don't use the word cost. But the same terminology in cost accounting is known as cost. Okay. So if anybody tells you cost and expenses are same, true or false? Yes. They are the same. It is a true statement. Okay. So I am locking the meeting room. Okay. So then When I say ये तो cost is divided as direct cost and indirect cost. Here, cost is further classified as direct cost and indirect cost. Okay, this is also one of the favorite questions of the paper setter. Yeah, classifying cost or different types of cost. Now, this cost is also further classified. So cost is divided as A and B, direct cost and indirect cost, and direct cost is further classified into three categories. ठीक है, तो आई विल नॉट टेल यू द थ्री कैटेगरीज राइट नाउ. ओके, लेट अस कीप इट एज अ सीक्रेट. बट आई विल टेल यू व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट एंड देन आई विल असोसिएट ऑल द थ्री कॉस्ट टू इट. देन यू विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट. ओके, नाउ द चैट बॉक्स इज ओपन. नाउ देयर इज वन क्वेश्चन व्हिच आई एम आस्किंग टू यू ऑल. लेट मी सी हाउ मच अटेंटिव यू वर इन द लास्ट लेक्चर्स. सो माय क्वेश्चन इज दिस कॉस्ट क्लासिफिकेशन ओके is coming under which cost accounting standard? Which cost accounting standards gives you this cost classification? Anyone who knows the answer, put it in the chat box. Cost classification or definitions in cost accounting is given under which cost accounting standard? Because whatever I'm teaching you comes from there. Okay, this is not my bifurcation. This is bifurcation given by CAS. So which CAS is applicable to cost classification? Okay, Atharva. Yeah, very good. It is CAS 1. Cost Accounting Standard 1 talks about cost classification. Very good. Okay, so aapke jitne bhi, okay Bhavesh, yeah, got it. So aapke jitne bhi definitions hai, whatever definitions you have in cost accounting. So from there comes cost classification. So it is all under the same heading, CAS 1. ठीक है, let us see what do you mean by direct cost as per CAS 1. Okay, so according to CAS 1, the definition of direct cost is, it is an expense. Please write it along with me. Yeah, just don't sit idle that side. Write it whatever I am saying. This will help. And yeah, this cost structure which I am teaching you, CAS 1, is very, very important for sum solving. So after this, the next thing I will do is cost sheet ka format. So if you don't understand this, then you will never understand cost sheet format also. Is that clear? Okay. So write along with me whatever pointers I am writing. Okay. So direct cost is a cost. It's an expense paid by the manufacturer. It is an expense paid by the manufacturer, which is variable and depends, which is variable and depends on units produced. Okay, so this is the definition as per CAS 1. Expenses paid by the manufacturer, which is variable and depends on units produced. So, direct cost ke do features hai. Pehla, it is variable. Second, it is dependent on units produced. Why have I highlighted this? क्योंकि आपको expenses या cost के नाम रट्टा नहीं करने हैं. You don't have to mug it up. You have to remember this thing. Okay? तो अगर मैं आपको कोई एक expense दे दूँ और मैं आपको बोलूँ कि ये कौन सा expense है, तो आपको पहले सोचना चाहिए. The expense should be, I mean the cost should be able to fulfill these two features. Okay? So for a cost, for an expense to be a direct cost, you have to satisfy two conditions. First, It has to be variable in nature. Variable means which keeps changing, which is not fixed. It has to be variable in nature and it should depend on units produced, number of units produced. अब इसका मतलब क्या होता है? What does this sentence mean? Okay? So let me give you an example over here and then you will understand. Okay? ठीक है? Now बिजनेस करने के लिए यू रिक्वायर टू थिंग्स. फर्स्ट इज रॉ मटेरियल, नेक्स्ट इज लेबर. फाइन. सो आई गिव यू एग्जाम्पल नंबर वन. ठीक है. फाइन. से आई एम अ मैन्युफैक्चरर ऑफ से पेन. से दिस इज अ पेन. ओके. आई एम मैन्युफैक्चरिंग दिस पेन. फाइन. नाउ व्हाइल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग दिस पेन, दिस इज अ स्टाइलस पेन. ओके. Fine. So it has lot of raw material is intact to it. So the body of the stylus pen, okay, the body of the stylus pen is of a plastic, okay, and inside the pen there is no ink, obviously, because it is a pen which is used for touchscreen laptops. Okay, so there must be a technique because of which the lead inside the pen, okay, is also its raw material. Agreed. Okay. So understand what I am saying. Okay, so for making this one pen, ये one stylus pen बनाने के लिए ये रहा pen. Say it requires 100 grams of plastic. Okay, this is this is manufactured by Microsoft. Right, so Microsoft company, for making this one stylus pen, they need 100 grams of plastic. Okay. So this, what I said, one pen, this is my finished goods. Okay, and this plastic, 100 grams of plastic, is my raw material. Agreed, everyone? Okay, to make one stylus pen, Microsoft needs 100 grams of plastic. Okay, fine. And this 100 grams of plastic is costing Microsoft, say, 1,000 rupees. Obviously, because this is not a simple plastic which you see. It's not that simple. Okay. So, say 100 grams of plastic is 1,000 rupees. Right. Now, see what is my next question to you all. You will put it in the chat box. So, if Microsoft is producing two pens, so it will need 200 grams of plastic. So what will be the raw material cost now? Put it in the chat box. Put it in the chat box. One pen, 100 grams of plastics, and 100 grams of plastics is for 1,000 rupees. So if I manufacture two pens, 200 grams of plastic, so what is the cost? Anyone? Yeah, very good. Yeah, very good. So the cost of plastic, the cost of the raw material is gonna be 2,000. So on. Agar three pens, so Microsoft will need 300 grams of plastic and the cost is gonna be 3,000. Okay, now what is my point of explaining this example to you is, okay, what did I tell you? It has to be, what are the features of direct cost? First, it has to be variable in nature. So see, it is variable when it is one pen, it is 1,000. When it is two pen, it is 2,000 rupees. When it is three pens, it is 3,000 rupees. Don't you feel the answer is changing? Huh? It is changing, na? Okay, so change is known as variable. Isko bolte hain variable. This is termed as variable in accounts. Theek hai? Now, what if I don't produce only pen, zero pens? There is no demand, so no pen, so no raw material, so no cost. अंडरस्टूड या तो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज अ वेरिएबल कॉस्ट. अगर तुम प्रोड्यूस करोगे तो तुमको पे करना है, नहीं करोगे तो तुमको नहीं करना है, कम करोगे तो कम पे करना है, ज्यादा करोगे तो ज्यादा पे करना है. इट इज लाइक दिस. ओके, तो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज वेरिएबल इन नेचर. एवरीवन क्लियर टिल हियर? जस्ट एक्नॉलेज इन द चैट बॉक्स, इज इट क्लियर टिल हियर? अंडरस्टूड व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से? द फर्स्ट फीचर ऑफ डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट, दैट इज वेरिएबिलिटी. Put it in the chat box if it is clear to you. Okay, fine. Very good. ठीक है, चलो अभी इसका हम next feature देखते हैं. What is the next feature? Variable तो मैंने बता दिया आपको. What is variable? Now it should depend on units produced. Obviously it is depending on units produced. One pen 1000, two pens 3000. तो ये जो है इसको बोलते हैं यूनिट्स प्रोड्यूस्ड. यूनिट्स प्रोड्यूस्ड मतलब आउटपुट. ओके, तो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज आउटपुट. सो इट इज वेरिएबल. ऑब्वियसली सी, इट इज वेरिएबल. ये वेरिएबल है. ओके ओके, दिस इज वेरिएबल. And see, units produced. It is depending on units produced, right? One pen 1000, two pen 2000, three pen 3000, zero pens, no, nothing to pay. Clear? Fine? Okay. So, next. Fine? So, this is an example of what? What example was this? This is an example of raw material. This is an example of raw material which I gave. So, मैंने आप लोगों को क्या बोला था students कि क्या होगा? I will be what? I will be dividing. Okay, direct cost का I will show you the division. Okay, so see, direct cost is divided as first direct material cost. Got the example clear? Direct material cost. Understood? मैंने क्या बोला? I will explain you direct cost. I'll give you an example and I'll associate it with the types of direct cost. Okay? So the first type of direct cost is direct material cost. Now let us come to the second one. Again, I'll give you an example. Okay, example number two. Example number two. Okay, now I am a manufacturer of say t-shirt. What am I? I am a manufacturer of a t-shirt. One t-shirt, एक टी शर्ट बनाने के लिए द लेबर इज चार्जिंग 150 रुपीज. आई रिपीट, आई एम अ मैन्युफैक्चरर ऑफ अ टी शर्ट एंड टू मेक वन टी शर्ट द टेलर, ऑब्वियसली हु इज द लेबर? द टेलर हु विल बी कटिंग द क्लॉथ एंड हु विल बी स्टिचिंग द क्लॉथ. सो दैट टेलर इज आस्किंग फ्रॉम मी 150 रुपीज. क्लियर? सो if I am manufacturing two t-shirts, obviously I'll pay him how much? 300. If I am manufacturing three t-shirts, I'm gonna pay him how much? 450. Okay, if I am not making the t-shirt, I will not pay him. Samajh mein aaya? Again, what is happening? 150, 300, 450. Isn't this variable? Correct? So, feature first, kya bolta direct cost? It should be variable. So, it is variable. Next feature, what is the next feature? It should depend on units produced. Yeah. Yes, it is in connection to units produced. One t-shirt 150, two t-shirt 300, three t-shirts 450, no t-shirt, no money. Okay, so this is called as also a direct cost. Okay, so the second type of direct cost is direct labor cost. So the second example which I gave you is of direct labor cost. Okay, and there is one third category also. This is clear to everyone. Please acknowledge in the chat box. Is this also clear? I explained you the definition of direct cost. Then I showed you the angles concerning to direct cost. First is direct material ka example, then direct labor ka example, and come to the third category. Okay. एग्जाम्पल नंबर थ्री. ओके, इसमें क्या एग्जाम्पल दूं मैं? नहीं, इट्स नॉट कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, बट आई नीड टू नो व्हाट एग्जाम्पल शुड आई कनेक्ट योर विद. ओके फाइन, चलो. आई एम अ कार मैन्युफैक्चरर. ओके, आई मैन्युफैक्चर कार्स. ठीक है, आई एम अ न्यू मैन्युफैक्चरर हु इज मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कार. ओके, सो माई सेल्स आर नॉट दैट ग्रेट. I am not able to sell my car the way I want to. Okay, I had expected my car sale would be 50,000 a year. 50,000 car I will be selling in a year, but I couldn't sell the car. Okay, so now what strategy will I do? Obviously, I don't want to end up my business. Okay, so I go and get a tie-up with. I'll tell you the tie-up is with. Okay, my drawing is not that great. Can anybody tell me ये कौन सी कार कंपनी का साइन है? Which car company's logo is this? Anyone? Which car company's logo is this? Okay, fine, cool. I thought guys would answer, but girls gave the right answer. Fine, chalo, very good. Mercedes, yeah. Okay, so this is Mercedes ka logo. Now, what I do as a manufacturer, I am not able to sell my car. I go and have a tie-up with Mercedes. Okay, now Mercedes is telling me, fine, madam, आप use कर सकते हो हमारा logo, but हर कार के पीछे आपको हमें 1 लाख रुपीज देना पड़ेगा. फॉर वन लोगो, वन कार विल हैव वन लोगो ना. हाँ, तो फॉर वन लोगो आई विल बी पेइंग देम 1 लाख रुपीज. अंडरस्टूड? सो इफ आई प्लान टू सेल 50 कार्स, सो यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड हाउ मच आई विल हैव टू पे देम. ओके, सो फॉर टू लोगोज दैट मीन्स टू कार्स आई विल बी पेइंग देम 2 लाख रुपीज. ओके, फॉर थ्री कार्स और थ्री लोगोज आई विल बी पेइंग देम 3 लाख रुपीज. ओके, अंडरस्टूड? सो क्या हुआ है इधर? क्या हो रहा है इधर? क्या हो रहा है? इट इज वेरिएबल. आई एम यूजिंग अ लाइट कलर. So, what is happening here, students? Yeah, I am paying for the logos depending on the number of cars I will manufacture. So, don't you guys feel this is variable in nature? It is changing and it is also dependent on units produced. ठीक है, fine. और दूसरी चीज, ये जो लोगो है, दिस लोगो ऑफ मर्सिडीज बेंज, दिस लोगो, इज दिस अ रॉ मटेरियल? नो. इज दिस अ लेबर? नो. दिस एग्जाम्पल इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ रॉयल्टी. यू आर पे, आई एम पेइंग रॉयल्टी टू मर्सिडीज फॉर यूजिंग देयर ब्रांड लोगो. ओके वाई? बिकॉज इट विल हेल्प टू बूस्ट माई सेल्स. ओके सो फाइन. तो दिस लोगो इज नॉट अ रॉ मटीरियल ऑफ द वॉट यू कॉल्ड ऑफ द यूनिट्स प्रोड्यूस्ड. मेरे फिनिश गुड्स का ये रॉ मटीरियल नहीं है. लोगो इज नॉट द रॉ मटीरियल ऑफ द कार. नीदर लोगो इज द डायरेक्ट लेबर ऑफ द कार. So anything that does not come in the category of material and labor, there is a third category to it known as direct expenses. I repeat, students, hear it, listen to me carefully. Things, I mean expenses or cost, which is not included in direct material, which is not included in direct labor. So CAS 1 has given a third category to such expenses or to such cost, and that category is known as direct expenses. Okay, why it is called direct expense? Because it has both the features. It is variable also in nature, and it depends on units produced also. It is not a raw material, it is not a labor. So the third category, which is open in CAS 1, is direct expenses. Am I clear to everyone? Post it in the chat box. Is this clear? Ma'am, can you please... Achha, you guys can't hear me. Now you can hear me? Now am I audible to everyone? Okay. Ma'am, can you please explain the last example again? Okay, fine. Okay. I'll explain the last example. Okay. I told you all that I am a car manufacturer. Okay, my cars are not doing great. I am not able to sell my cars as what I had expected. So I go on with a tie-up with Mercedes. Okay, so this is the logo of Mercedes. Fine. What did I say? Mercedes allows me to use their logo. I have a tie-up with them. Now, tie-up means what? They will not manufacture my car. They will not make cars for me. They will only give their logo to me. Only the logo will be given of Mercedes. I'm using their logo. So for every logo which I will be using in my car, they are going to charge me 1 lakh rupees. Okay. So that is known as royalty. They are not manufacturing for me, but they are giving their brand. They are lending away their brand to me so that I can boost up with my sales. Okay. So that is not going to be done for free. So for one logo, it is 1 lakh. So for 2 logos, it is 2 lakhs. For 3 logos, it is 3 lakhs. Okay. So what is happening? It is variable, because 1 logo, 1 lakh, it is changing. See, the values are changing. 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 3 lakh. The values are changing, means it's variable in nature. Plus, it is dependent on units produced. For 1 logo, 1 lakh, 2 logos, 2 lakhs, 3 logos, 3 lakhs. So it is satisfying both the conditions of variable cost. Clear, everyone? It is satisfying both the conditions of variable cost. It is, and the logo which I have been using of Mercedes, it is not a raw material of my car. Neither logo is a direct labor of my car. So when the expenses don't fall in the first two categories, the third category is direct expenses. Okay, so this is how it is. Okay, see, I cannot categorize it under material labor. So there is a third category known as direct expense category. Okay. Now is it clear? Acknowledge it in the chat box. Okay. Fine. So direct, thank you students for acknowledging. Now last 10 minutes are there, so you can start giving your attendance. Yeah, don't forget your attendance, start giving your attendance, right? And simultaneously listen also to whatever I'm saying. Okay. So direct cost is clear to everyone? Okay. Now I'll give you one more example in direct cost. Okay, one more. Example number three only. Actually, I'm continuing with direct expense ka example only. Okay. Now look over the screen. Look into the screen, whatever I'm writing. Okay. I am a manufacturer of soap. I manufacture what? Soap. Okay. So to make soap, I need to give, say the shape of the soap is round. Moti soap pata hai na? Round shape ka hota hai. Okay. So I deal into 2-3 shapes of soap. I make a round soap. I make a rectangular shape soap. I make a oval shape ka. Okay. Circle. This is rectangular. Just giving an example, students. And this is oval shape ka soap. Okay. This is round shape. Okay. So, ye mera soap ka sizes hai jo main market mein I sell it off. Theek hai? Abhi, I'm not talking about soap ka raw material. Neither I'm talking about, you know, soap ka labor. Okay. Soap banane ke liye waise bhi labor ki zyada zarurat nahi hai. उसके लिए आपको क्या चाहिए? मोल्ड्स. ओके, व्हाट आर दीस मोल्ड्स? व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय मोल्ड्स? ओके, दिवाली में मम्मी बनाती होगी ना करंजी, तो उसका एक साचा आता है जिसमें उसको डालते हैं तो वो करंजी का शेप लेता है, बराबर ना? साचा. तो दैट साचा इज नोन एज मोल्ड्स. ओके, दे आर or they are devices which give shapes to your finished goods. Okay, so cost of molds, I repeat, cost of molds. As a manufacturer, as a soap manufacturer, I will have to purchase 3 molds. One is round shape, one is rectangular shape, and one is oval shape. Okay, fine. And now I will connect you all with the definition of cost. Okay, yaad hai cost definition mein maine kuch bola tha aap log ko. It's an expense which is paid by the manufacturer for converting raw material into finished goods. Correct? Yeah. Students, video on, please. Why are the videos off? Why are few of the videos off? Switch on the video. Otherwise, I will not mark you present. Okay. So, this conversion, I told you, what is this conversion as per Casman? It means converting, change in the shape, size, color, structure, taste, smell of the raw material. Change in the size, shape, size, and color of the raw material. Okay. Now, what is happening in this example? The example which I gave you all, the example which I have given to you all is, isme the shape is changing. Okay. And anything, any expense, any cost which is borne for all these things, if there is a change in the shape, size, color, a structure, taste, smell, okay, it is a direct cost. Okay, it is a direct cost. Okay, so in this example of molds, This is molds, is changing the shape. It is contributing in the change of the shape of the raw material. Yes, so it is a direct cost. Okay, understood? So even this is direct cost. So it is variable to hai hai, and it is dependent on number of units produced. Plus, there is an addition to this. What is the addition? It should also contribute in the change in the size, shape, color, taste, form, structure, smell of the raw material. Am I clear to everyone? Okay. And these molds are not raw material. They are not labor. So they will be categorized under direct expense. This third category. Okay. We'll come to this. Yeah. This. So here, this third category. Clear everyone? Okay. I'll give you now last 3 minutes are there. So one more example I'll give you, which will come under direct expense. Okay. Direct material, direct labor is very easy because only raw material you have to identify and the labor you have to identify. But direct expense, may you have to see all these things. It should be other than material, other than labor. Okay. So next. So I give you the example of the royalty, that is the logo of Mercedes. Then I give you the example of soap, in which I give you example of the molds. Okay. And next thing is example number 3 only I am doing. The same example I will take. Okay. Now here, say for example, okay, my raw material is converted into finished goods. ठीक है, and in between जो WIP है, work in progress है, it requires say process 1, process 2, process 3. Okay, तो I need 3 machines to convert my raw material into finished goods. ठीक है, what is happening is I have machine 1, I have machine 2. But I don't have this machine with me. Understood? Yeah. I have this machine. I have this machine. I don't have this machine. So what would I do? I outsource. I give it to some manufacturer who has that machine and who will convert my raw material into finished goods. Okay. So is this person going to work for me for free? No. He's going to charge me something. So that is called as higher charges. Higher charges matlab bhaada dena. मैं उसका मशीन यूज करने वाली हूँ ना, भले उसके फैक्ट्री में है लेकिन यूज तो मेरी वजह से हो रहा है, राइट? तो वो मुझसे भाड़ा लेगा, तो दैट इज नोन एज हायर चार्जेस फॉर स्पेशल इक्विपमेंट्स. हायर चार्जेस फॉर स्पेशल इक्विपमेंट्स. ओके, एंड स्पेशल इक्विपमेंट्स मीन्स मशीन्स व्हिच इज नॉट ओन्ड बाय यू, इट यू आर टेकिंग फ्रॉम समवन एंड यू आर पेइंग रेंट फॉर दैट. And such machines are important for converting your WIP, that is raw material stage, into the finished good stage. Okay. So what word did I use? I used the word conversion. I used the word conversion. So anything which is converting, any expense you're paying for that is a direct cost as per CAS 1. Am I clear? Okay, so this higher charges is not a material, it is not a labor, it is will come in the third category, expense. Clear everyone? Just acknowledge it in the chat. Okay, so next lecture we will start with something new. Okay, next lecture I'll start with indirect cost.